chair of the California State Judiciary Committee banning the use of the words he and she as pronouns during hearings. Watch this.
We are now a state recognizing the non-binary designation as a gender. We are using the phrase they and replacing other designations so that it's a gender-neutral designation of they. Basically, that's the primary reforms and revisions to the committee rules.
Mm-hmm. So here now to react is editor at Spiked Online, Brendan O'Neill. Brendan, no longer can you say he and she. She wants everyone to say they.
It's crazy. It really shows how far the politically correct lobby are willing to go in terms of policing language. They now want to control not just hateful language and racist language, which we can all agree is a bad thing, but everyday speech, he and she, the words that people use all the time in everyday conversation to describe men and women. They want to dig down so far into how we speak and ultimately into how we think that they are willing to ban the most common words mm-hmm. in the English language.
Well, her idea, because it goes back to the very beginnings of when you learn the English language, mm-hmm. you use he and she. But she said you can't use those in this room during the hearings. You got to use they. Here she is breaking her own rule.
So that we are using what my grammar teacher would have had a heart attack over. We are using the phrase they. My grammar teacher is long gone, and I won't be hearing from her. And if any of you...
From them,
exactly. From they.
Won't be hearing from her.
It's almost impossible to
do. It's impossible. I mean, it's crazy. It's like... No one speaks like that. You know, right. Normal people just don't use the word they.
What's wrong with he and she? Why does she want to change this?
You know, I think it's down to, there's a kind of transgender extremism at the moment. Now, I'm fully in favor of trans rights. I think trans people should have the same rights as everybody else.
Of course.
But there is this kind of trans extremism which presumes that anyone who uses words like he or she is being disrespectful to trans people or disrespectful to non-binary people or even possibly transphobic, which is a word that's invented to describe the use of this kind of language. So I think a lot of politicians, a lot of people in the public eye feel that they need to go along with this new form of speech policing and feel that it's the way to show that you are woke and on message and politically correct. So they're going along with it. But I think there are a lot of people out there who will be thinking, what is this about? How on earth can it be possible for a public figure to ban he and she?
Right. Two things. One, do you think this is going to spread? And number two, what's the danger of it?
I think it is going to spread. I think we've seen similar developments in the United Kingdom, for example, where feminists who are critical of transgender politics are hounded and harassed and their meetings are closed down simply because they think we should still have the right to talk about men and women. They argue that trans women should have rights, but they're not necessarily real women. They make these kinds of arguments, and they are increasingly controversial and unacceptable opinions to hold. So I think there's a real... there's an element of authoritarianism creeping into the trans movement where they aren't simply arguing for their rights, but they're also trying to control how the rest of us speak and think, which I think is a step too far.
Okay, Brendan O'Neill. Thank you, Brendan.
Thank you.
Great to have you here.